I'm Will Shiers. I'm the editor of Commercial Motor magazine in the UK. And I'm about to drive this 34-ton Scania 40R all the way from Trissel in Norway to Scania's hometown of Södertälje in Sweden. It's about 550 kilometres, so it's the perfect opportunity to test the drivability, to use the new Scania charging access card, and most importantly, to see what the range is really like. Now, we've all heard horror stories about what happens to battery electric vehicles when it gets cold, and it's minus 23 degrees here. So this will be interesting. We've done 300 kilometres today. I've been thoroughly impressed with the truck, and in particular, the range. So when we got to the Swedish border, we were on 200 kilometres and we still had 40% left. I know we could have done it all in one hit, but we stopped at an Ionity charging station, topped it up to 100 and carried on. So no, all good so far. Well, that was an absolute joy to drive. Whatever your feelings are on electric trucks, put them behind you, have a drive in one of these. It is fantastic, so smooth, effortless in fact. Instant torque, you don't notice the gear changes. It does everything you expect from a Scania, only that little bit quieter and that little bit smoother. So compared with a diesel truck, well, it's the same, just better. The card worked perfectly, but there isn't enough public charging, at least not truck-friendly public charging, even here in Sweden and in Norway. Now, Scania have done exactly what legislators asked. They've come to the party with a perfectly good truck. Now, we need an infrastructure throughout Europe to support it. When Scania launched this, they claimed a range of 350 kilometres, and I'll be honest with you, I was doubting that. But it's done it. In fact, it's exceeded it. It's been so cold today, and that range is exactly what Scania said it would be. So yesterday evening, we charged our Ionity on a 350 kilowatt charger, and that let us take the charge from 36% to 100% in 46 minutes. So that's perfect for a driver's 45-minute break. I've thoroughly enjoyed the experience, especially learning how to drive an electric truck properly. It's not the same as a diesel. You have to be thinking ahead all the time and regenerating whenever you can. Today, I must say, was a bit stressful, at least to begin with, knowing we had to do 300 kilometres in sub-zero temperatures on one charge, but I needn't have worried. It's finished with 26% left.